Engage. Disrupt. Adapt. Repeat. You're listening to Pure Reinvention, the podcast for curious people.
Welcome to this episode of Pure Reinvention, where we create space for the unexpected by inspiring a reinvention lifestyle. And for our podcast guests, welcome to 2018. I think 2018 is going to be an exciting year for many of us. We are certainly looking forward to 2018 at Pure Reinvention with all of the wonderful things that we have planned for you. And joining me for the month of January of 2018 is Bonifer Ballard. Bonifer, welcome to Pure Reinvention.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
Bonifer, tell us a little bit about your background and how you've been able to embrace some of the Pure Reinvention concepts, if you would.
Well, I have about 25 years in nonprofit management experience, but my first employment experience was in the U.S. military. So I'm very driven by mission. I also don't like to sit still for very long. So the Pure Reinvention method, it resonated with me.
Bonifer, your current responsibilities are what?
I'm currently the executive director of the Michigan section of the American Water Works Association, a small nonprofit here in Michigan focused on training and education for water professionals.
And really trying to bring a whole new perspective to association management and the deliverables and the value that membership gets.
Right. One of the things that really drew me to the position was that we hadn't had staff previously. So I had the opportunity to really create the role in my vision in the way that I saw it. And it's been a learning process. The board went through its own sort of reinvention process to decide to hire an executive director.
Right.
And I think we're probably in the simplify phase. We're not quite through the whole process. We still have a little ways to go, but it's been really exciting and a lot of fun, really, to see everybody grow and embrace the change.
Well, Bonifer, you're joining us as the co-host for the month of January while we are discussing the fifth step in the peer reinvention process, which is move. And for many people, move becomes a very difficult step because that's where it begins to start achieving those things that you set your mind to go do. Yet, it really and truly, if you do the steps prior correctly, the move is actually the easiest step, isn't it?
Right. I think that's what we're all looking for, is the move part. But I think it's also where people get stuck. And I think you're right. I think if people follow the process correctly, the move becomes much easier.
So in 2018, we're very committed here at Pure Reinvention to making sure we're supporting you as you are practicing the steps to Pure Reinvention, and more importantly, developing the infrastructure to help move your organization to this next phase that you have envisioned as an executive leader. And because executive leadership is so important, I think, Bonifer, we should be telling people about the new executive leadership experience that you have actually helped us identify that we are going to be having in May of 2018. So let's kick that off that thought to kind of talk about what 2018 is going to look like.
Well, I'm really excited about this event in May. Right now, we're calling it Connect Detroit. It's definitely a work in progress, but I'm really excited about the things we've talked about. A lot of that is around this experience that we're trying to create for executives. I think one of the things that, as executive leaders, we often don't find the kinds of professional development experiences that are really meaningful, that really help us change how we work every day. And what we are creating in this Connect Detroit event can do that, I think. So I'm looking forward to going. I'm looking forward to fleshing out more of the content. I think it's going to be a really exciting event.
Why did you approach Pure Reinvention with your thought that it was time for this kind of an experience to be available to the leaders in the reinvention process who are ready?
That's easy. As I looked around to get my own professional development, short of going back to get a PhD, there really wasn't any opportunity in Michigan that I could find that offered me something different than what I had already been to. Being in the professional world for 25 years, having gone through college and graduate school, okay, I've done all that. What's next? I needed something. I'm looking for something that's really going to stimulate me in a new way. And there just didn't seem to be anything out there.
Bonifer, you've mentioned a couple of times the more academic experience and history that we have as executives and more typical education, professional development.
Mm-hmm.
You were very adamant that any kind of professional development that you thought was valuable needed to be more experiential. It needed to be something that moved away from PowerPoint presentations and away from the sterile environment of the classroom to actually getting in the real world and actually experiencing and learning from peers and from the project rather than from kind of the academic download of a PowerPoint.
Exactly.
Explain why that's so important for executive leaders in this phase of their development.
I think there's a place for PowerPoint for sort of traditional classroom learning, but you get to a point in your career where you can almost predict what the next slide is going to say. You can almost predict what that speaker is going to do. And instead of being a passive participant in that professional development process, I think it's important for high-functioning executives to get their hands dirty, right?
Yes.
Roll up your sleeves and actually solve the problem that you're talking about.
Get into the learning
experience.
That's
exactly right.
And so you are helping us with Connect Detroit find those experiences which allow a key group of leaders. And this is a very interesting thing we should probably mention. This is a limited experience, isn't it?
Right. We talked a lot about the fact that you can only have so many people in a room to have that kind of experience. And I say room, it may not be a room, but it's important to limit the number of people because you can't do the same kind of thing with a room, a ballroom of 1,000 people.
Right. So all of our experiences at Pure Reinvention are along that same kind of platform, mm-hmm. where with a limited size group, we're able to actually immerse people into the experience so
right.
they can actually feel and be a part of what that is rather than just learning about it kind of from the outside. And what that allows participants to engage in is an awareness and the connectivity that goes with ownership of the project so that when they begin to move away from passive awareness of information to actually active ownership of movement, that's the kind of interaction we want to help either in a case of starters, people new to the peer reinvention process, or in the case of our May 22nd event, where we actually engage executives in the immersion process so that they are able to see themselves owning and moving a project forward.
Right.
And for the move step, that's critically important because we don't have the ability to teach that in a more academic environment. It is absolutely what key executives are expected to do within their organizations is move it forward. But we really don't have a good platform for doing that traditionally. And your insistence that it was an opportunity for peer reinvention to look at that from an executive standpoint, which is what moved us to the May 22nd experience. So, Bonifer, thank you for that.
Well, I'm really glad you did, and I'm looking forward to the event.
Well, I think that one of the ways that we can honestly recommend to leaders that is very important in the reinvention journey is the feedback loop and learning about the opportunities that are available in your marketplace. So by learning, listening to Bonifer, listening to those key individuals that you trusted were feeding you information about the need in the marketplace, right? We're able to put this event together and bring 50 key engaged ownership executives together who really want to be a part of a non-traditional learning experience, which allows them to move their education forward in a way that, as Bonifer, as you mentioned, in a way in which those kind of experiences just are not available to most executives.
Right.
So for an executive that is ready, Bonifer, what would you say are kind of the key characteristics of an executive that's ready to move forward?
It would be really important for that person to have a sense of courage. I was going to say fearlessness, but you can still be scared.
Right.
But you got to be courageous because this is not a professional development experience where you're going to sit in the back row and check your email.
Kind of hide.
Right? Mm-hmm. So I think that's number one. You got to be courageous. You got to be willing to go where maybe is a little bit uncomfortable for you personally.
Mm-hmm. And that's where growth usually happens,
exactly,
right?
Exactly. Yep. Exactly. I think the person would need to be open to looking at things in a new way. And I hesitate to say that because I think it's a little trite. We all hear that, to look at things in a new way, to
right.
think out of the box.
Yeah.
But this is what we're crafting for Connect Detroit. Isn't your typical professional development experience. And so people are going to be surprised at what they're introduced to, and it's going to be uncomfortable, and it's not going to feel like they expect it to feel. And they've got to be okay with that so that they can be ready to take in the experience and do something with it.
So at the end of the day, when they walk away after having immersed themselves in that, they walk away and say, wow, I hadn't been a part of something like that, and I'm glad I did.
Exactly.
The reason this is so important to bring this to executives, and I see this all the time. Executives will say, well, I allow my people to explore and try new things, and it doesn't really matter if I'm doing it because I'm letting them do it. Mm-hmm. But the reality is, if that key executive is not the first one in Bonifer, what is that message that's being sent to the rest of the staff if their boss is not really engaged in that process?
Yeah, I think it's really important for the executive to set the tone and maybe even blaze the trail in some cases. It's too easy for people to stay in their comfort zone for whatever reason and whatever topic. And so the executive really needs to take that first step into unknown territory so that they can then inspire their staff to follow.
And that's probably one of the keys that we want to focus on in 2018 is pure reinvention to the executive in charge, right? To the key leader who can really allocate resources in a meaningful way to really make some demonstrative change that's obviously available to anyone in the marketplace that's ready, is a part of our focus in making sure that they have the tools and experiences, right? Getting back to our May 22nd event, those experiences, those interactions, those networks with other key executives who can help each other and support each other and ultimately share in the success that each of them will gain in 2018 as well. So Bonifer, thank you for being a part of our January podcast schedule, but more importantly, thank you for stepping in and stepping up and being a part of helping Pure Reinvention recognize a much-needed opportunity in the marketplace. For that, we're deeply grateful.
My pleasure.
If you're ready for a change, make it a change that lasts. Make it Pure Reinvention.
Thanks for listening to this episode of Pure Reinvention. Keep the conversation going and get alerts when new podcasts are up by following us on Twitter @PureReinvention or sign up for our mailing list at purereinvention.com.